Should we also be, you know, focusing more on children? Like the indoctrination which has happened from the West over the years started with the child, you know, when he was still young.
Yes.
So how do we plan to go about it?
Yeah, we were raised on this Baba, black sheep and this kind of stuff, you know, which doesn't make any sense. Just completely alienated. And we have amazing stories, we have amazing chants, and, you know, I think that in the unconscious mind, Sanskrit, its vibrations will, if you put them, even when the child is in the womb, you put those, and when the child is young and the child is growing up and the stories you tell, it has an effect on that child later in life.
Yes, it does.
So we have to do all that. We have to introduce that. Now it is up to parents to lobby in the school system and ask them to change.
No, I just wanted to add something more. You know, just yesterday I saw probably a lady from Southeast Asia somewhere, and you know, probably a Japanese, and the child was playing on that tab with a Japanese cartoon. You know, so the culture today has got, you know, more associated with the applications and the cartoons and whatever appeals to children. So I believe, shouldn't we be doing something?
Yes, I think we should be developing multimedia. We should be developing, using all the technology to bring education, you know, excite and challenge all the senses. If you think about it, I have written an argument here that the writing is not superior to oral. I've written an argument in this book. Okay. Most of the human history of evolution was not writing, but knowledge was accumulating.
Yes.
So your senses, your eyes, are parallel processing. They're not linear processing like writing. Parallel, when you see this room, you're seeing a lot of things. When you go in a forest, you're seeing a lot of things simultaneously. Yeah, you're not looking at it linearly, sequentially. And when you are experiencing a forest, you are experiencing it with your ears, with your nose, with your touch, all these, all the senses simultaneously. It's a multi-sensory or multimedia processing cognition that human beings and animals have. Writing is very artificial because you don't use smell, you don't use hearing, you don't use your touch, you don't use anything, and even the sight is monochrome and one directional. It's at point some percent of the total cognitive apparatus that gets used. The 99 point some part of your cognitive apparatus is atrophying. It's just being setting aside. So people say that literacy makes you advanced. I think it makes you one-dimensionally better off. It is necessary, but it should not be at the expense of the other senses being used for education. So the education system we've had, which had music and drama and storytelling, you know, mathematics in my grandfather's school, he's a math teacher in village. The mathematics tables were taught singing. They would say 3 times 4 is 12, like that. There was certain intonation. That's how Vedic style is a musical. Now they found out, there's this guy called Georgi Lozanov, who died now. He developed something called accelerated learning. And accelerated learning is a rave in the West. Now they're sending their kids to accelerated learning schools. If you dig up the history of accelerated learning, it started with this man called Lozanov. He is the founding father of this whole theory of accelerated learning. And he said you should give the child left brain, right brain, multiple kinds of stimuli, not just one dimensional. And the encoding in the neural system is better that way. So, and he got it from India, because in the 1950s, the Russians sent people to India to see if there were some psychic powers the yogis had, which might have military applications. CIA also studied, by the way, Patanjali Yoga Sutra. And there was a huge project, because they wanted to know, can you float and can you do distance vision, can you tell where the enemy's missiles are, maybe some yogis can be trained. So they were both CIA and the Soviets had, for some time they were studying these things. Now this man Georgi Lozanov was a neuroscientist sent to India. He came back and said, I found one thing which is extraordinary human capability that they have, and that's memory. And they can memorize 100,000 verses and keep chanting it by heart, and they do it correctly. And he, as a neuroscientist, he didn't know how it's even possible, because there's no neuroscientific explanation of how somebody could learn so much memorization. So he wanted to know how they memorize so much. And he says, one thing that is interesting, they're using both brains. They're chanting. There's an intonation with which the verse is memorized. And there's a very carefully designed intonation. So in his book, he records and he comes up with all these styles of intonation that they're using in chanting, and which one is optimum and how it helps. So based on that, he developed a theory of accelerated learning. And he says that if you learn through multiple senses, you will learn faster and you will learn better. Now, this is an example of Sanskrit feeding accelerated learning in the West, enhancing their ability to learn. And then someday some of those missionaries will set up an accelerated learning school here, and you will say, this is an American gift to us.